Are you looking for a solid solution for your podcasts, interviews, recordings, live streams? Well, Riverside has you covered. One of their main features is that you can actually record these streams in 4K. That means that if you're looking for quality, Riverside is the way to go. On this video, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to do a live recording test. I'm also going to stream on a Facebook fan page and all of this just to show you how easy it is to use Riverside. So stick around and let's head on over to my desktop right now. All right, this is the Riverside FM page. If you guys want to check it out, that link will be in the description. Now there's a quick demo on the main page that you can see right here. One of their main features is the 4K recording. If you're looking for quality, Riverside is the way to go. Now we have an example here of what would happen. On the left, we have a cloud recording, and on the right, we have local recording. We have great signal, but it's recording at 720p. But if the signal goes halfway, well, the quality just goes really bad and it goes blurry on cloud recording. But local recording stays 4K, and that's what you're going to get. You can download 4K or any other resolution that's below that. Now, like I mentioned before, it's trusted by big name brands like Spotify, TED, Marvel, Fox, and many more. Now, let's go jump over to the dashboard. One of the first things I want to show you is how easy it actually is to start recording, going live, invite people, and actually stream to a Facebook fan page if that's something that you want. But it's super easy to stream to all your social media accounts. Now, let me go into my SaaS testing page, and I'm going to start a brand new recording. I'll get into these settings in a bit, but I want to go with the main features first. So let's go start with a new one. And this is testing for video. That's what I'm gonna call it. And yes, I want audio and video. And if you only want audio, that is possible also. We can start right now or we can schedule this. Now, for example, if you have a meeting that you want to schedule, I don't know, 3 days in advance, well, you can start it now, have a link ready, invite people, and you can send them into a waiting room if you like. So when you go live, they all go into the same room and go live. For now, we're just starting studio now because we're testing it really quickly. Okay, here we go. What is my name? Well, that's the one. Let me connect my DSLR. Let me see if I can do both at the same time. All right, yeah, I'm still recording and it should go. There we go. Okay, so I'm using my DSLR for the same purpose here. That's my name. I am not using headphones. I can select if I'm using headphones because one of the other cool features that Riverside has is that it can actually fix the audio to remove fan noise, a lot of little clicks, and all that kind of good stuff. So I'm good to go. Default MacBook, that's my microphone, and there we go. Okay, so this is the main studio. We have several settings available here. Let's get started with recording, and then we'll go from there with the settings, okay? So this is my link if I want to invite guests, audience, or producer. Let's start the recording. Let's wait for that to load. All right, the countdown has started and I can start streaming right now inside of Riverside. So people can join in. I can chat with them via the chat right here. They can send me messages. I can respond to them. I can respond through video, through the chat. I have my studio. So for example, right now you can see I am peaking. You can see the red right there on the audio. Sometimes I peak because I speak loud. Well, I can lower the volume a bit so it doesn't peak and it doesn't hear that muffled sound. Now, if we have guests also speaking here, we can also move the volume there so it doesn't peak. So it's like it's kind of like a studio inside of Riverside. Now, before we get into those settings, I want to show you how easy it actually is to stream to social media accounts. So let me go into the settings section and we have the live stream. And we have options available: YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Twitch, LinkedIn, and custom RTMP. With custom RTMP, basically you can stream to anywhere you want. In this case, we're gonna do Facebook, and I'm going to grab the settings. So you're actually going to learn how to stream to a fan page. So this is my fan page. If you haven't liked my page, go ahead and search for it on Facebook and like it. I will leave the link in the description also. So what are we gonna do? Well, we're gonna click on live. We're gonna go live and we should receive our settings that we're going to use on Riverside, okay? Wait for that to load. Okay, there we go. We have the streaming key and we have the server URL. So let's copy the server URL, go back to Riverside, and this is the stream URL, and we also need the key. So this is a key for this one. Let's go ahead and paste it. There we go. Settings saved. Let's close this for now. Let's go back into our Facebook fan page, and we should see our stream in a bit. Right now, what it's doing, it's sending the data from Riverside to our Facebook page. Okay, so let's wait for that to load. Let's actually start it, stop and start, because it won't do it that way. Okay, start it now. Okay, there we go. And let's wait for that to load, and it should load it over there on Facebook. Okay, got that there. Let's go back here, and there we go. There we go. It sent the feed to here. We gotta wait for it to load a bit. And again, I don't have really great internet, so that's something that you should be aware of. So, okay, I'm here. What do I have to do next? Well, I'm gonna set a title. In this case, this is just testing for video. Riverside FM description, testing again. All right, again, this is just for testing purposes. And we can go live now. And I'll show you that in a bit. I will open it up in my phone just to show you how easy this is. Let's go open up my... Here we go, let's wait for it to load. Here it is. I am actually live already here. See that, how easy that was? And I will stop this recording because I'm just doing this for testing purposes. And that's how easy it is to stream to social media accounts. Now, what can we do here? Okay, so we're recording. We can actually share our screen if that's something that we want to do. We just click on this. We allow the permissions because at the first time that you're going to stream to the desktop, it's gonna ask you for permissions to allow it. We can share the whole screen, a particular window, or a particular Chrome tab. So for example, I can share this particular tab and not the whole window. Let's wait for that to load. Okay, and I should have shared another one. Chrome tab, it's this one. Okay, there we go. So I'm actually streaming this and people are watching this. I can stop sharing, which I am going to go back here. And you can do that also, okay? So you can share the screen, work on that screen, and people are going to view that screen, plus they're going to also view you in a little thumbnail, okay? What else can we do? We can change the mic settings. We can stop it, the speaker, change it to another one. The camera, if we have several cameras available, we can also switch between these. We have the studio information, which I showed you. We can mute it, we can lower it so we don't peak. There's options available, for example, the quality that this one's that is using, the uploaded, the platform, in this case is web. There's also the iOS app available if you guys want to use that. The inputs, the echo cancellation is active. So if there's echo in the room, it's gonna automatically fix it, okay? We can turn it off and preview recording. We can't do it while we're actually streaming. We have media things, for example, there's clapping, cheering, and a lot of them. I can preview them. So if I click on it, I can preview it. Let's click on it. Okay, that means I'm previewing it. It's not sounding for the users, okay? But if I hit live, it will do it. So for example, if I click on cheering, and just like that, people are actually hearing that, and it can make it more interactive instead of being a boring live stream that's just straightforward, okay? So there's a lot of them that you can use. You can search around, and right now it's in beta, so they are adding way more of these. And we have the chat, like I mentioned before, we can do that really easily. If we want to invite a guest, an audience, a producer, we can just share the link, open it up in the app, and just log in. And there's several people or two people or just one streaming at the same time, and we can talk to each other for an interview, a podcast, or whatever you want to use this for. Now on the top, you're viewing that it's actually recording and uploading 99% as of the video that we're going so far, right? But again, we're still recording, so it's still not finishing. But once we're done, it's going to do it. Cool features about Riverside is that, like I mentioned before, you can download up to 4K, and it also provides you the transcript. You can download the transcript in text and SRT file to later use it on another platform if you want to upload the video somewhere else. Okay, on the left, we have the amount of people who are live right now, which is just me, okay? But that's how easy it is to stream. Let's go back to our main dashboard to show you how the video looks when you download it, how the transcript looks, and then head into settings, okay? The upload is complete, so that's done. And let's go back to our main dashboard. Okay, let me open up this one, view recordings. This was a previous recording that I did, and it's separated. We have a WAV file, if we just want the audio. We have the MP4, the constant frame rate MP4. We have the recordings available right here if you want to use them. And another recordings because I stopped and played also on that test I was making, okay? We can download these if we like. We have a magic editor if we want to edit these. And we have the magic editor projects. So right here, I have a 4K video from the video I was testing yesterday. I can download it, which is this one right here, which I already downloaded. So let me show you that right now. It's testing this one. Get info. I want to show you that it's actually 4K. So this video weighed 336 megabytes. And here are the dimensions. So 3,840 by 2,160 pixels. All right. So that is 4K. Let me go ahead and open up really quickly just to show you. Just swift through it really quickly. And there you go. I'm not going to play it because I don't want to waste your time. We also have the transcript. Okay. In this case, it's going to load it. I already have loaded the transcript, but it does take a bit for it to give you the output. Okay. So in this case, it was just me. But if there were more people talking, well, we get the transcript for each one of them with their own name. We can download the SRT file and we can download the text file. So it's pretty cool that we're also getting this to use it later on. Maybe we want to view it by text. Maybe you want to send it out to a host or you want to upload it so someone can see it. There are several reasons why you might need the transcript. Now, let me go into the good stuff, all right? Which are the settings. Why? Because you're going to know how powerful RIVERSIDE actually is. Let me go into, is it the production settings? No, it's general settings. No, it's not actually that one. It's the recording settings. Okay, so here in the recording settings, these are the default settings that we're going to use for the times that we stream. For example, there's a recording type. We want it by default, audio and video. The recording quality, like I mentioned before, you can go up to 4K or you can do it lower, 1080p, 720p, or 480p. The frame rate, we have options for 24 frames per second or 29.97 frames per second. What does that mean? Let's just say if we're doing a headshot video where I'm not actually moving a lot, 24 frames per second is good enough. Why? Because it's gonna make the file size smaller. You don't need a large file size if you don't need 30 frames per second. Now, if I am streaming a dancing video where I'm going to move a lot, then I would use 30 frames per second, okay? You can separate tracks for internet recordings if you like. The audio, you have the option for 44.1 kilohertz or 48 kilohertz. And we also have the noise suppression option to turn on or off. In this case, I am in a controlled environment. There's no noise going on. There's no even fan noise, so I don't turn it on. But if you have noises going on, then I would suggest that you turn it on. And it's a pretty cool option that we have to have it there, okay? For general settings, we can do the studio types in private, public. We can enable the waiting room, which I would recommend. For example, if you schedule a podcast, well, you want users to come in once it's almost ready and you want them to join in the waiting room. Once it goes live, everyone goes to the live room. You have live call settings, you have data save, and you have options for 240p or 480p, or just go full frame, all right? Design, we have logo upload there. The live stream settings, you can, like you saw on this video, I can set them up on the studio or I can set them up here beforehand, okay? And the advanced settings, if you want to upload control, the auto or manual. I would keep it auto because it's just gonna do everything the way it should and we're not going to stress the computer. Production settings, it's just the name of products. Production team, if you want to invite, so we have the option for admin, director, and editor, and the production studio here. I'm just going to make one of these really quickly, which is a setup for later, because you might want to do that, because you might want to schedule a podcast.
Well, all you have to do is select there, like the option there. We're going to schedule and we're going to select the date. We're going to say it's going to be the 12th. Let's close that there. It's going to be at, it's fine. I don't know. 12:02 p.m. and select the time zone. Time zone is really important. Don't forget to set the time zone and set it correctly because it's going to start when you actually set it. So I'm going to select Pacific time, submit. We have the add participants if we like from now, guests, audience, and producers, and we can create the show. Now, once we create the show, we have several settings here, and one of the most important ones is that you actually grab the link so you can share it. So here we have our link, so people start signing up and actually join in the waiting room before it starts, okay? Remember, we have the waiting room available there. So basically, that is Riverside. Like I mentioned before, their main feature is to give you the output of 4K video, give you a transcript, and also the noise suppression. Plus, you can stream really quickly and fast with Riverside. Well, there you go. My name's George, this is Askmaster, and I'll see you guys later.